Hi everyone, today we show how to use buttons on NuttX. First, open code blocks to show you how to define the buttons. Open the NuttX project. Inside headers, configs, STM32F103 minimal board, include open board.h. Here you need to define the numbers of buttons you have in the board, 2 in this case. Define the name for each buttons and the bit for each buttons. In the STM32F103 minimal board.8, you need to define the GPIO pins for each buttons. Also, you need to define the minimal hierarchy buttons, maximum hierarchy buttons, and the number of hierarchy buttons. Okay, now you need to put these GPIO definitions inside the STM32Buttons.c in the source STM minimal. Okay. Here, just put the buttons in the sequence you want. I drew a small circuit to show the buttons debouncing. Basically, we have the button volume plus, resistor pull up, and capacitor to ground. And when you press the button, the ground go to A0 to GPIO pin. We have the same block. Also, I drew a layout in the freezing to make it easy to build the circuit. So basically, we have a wire connect the GPIO A0 to one side of the button and the resistor to pull up and the capacitor and the other side connect to ground. And we have another wire to second button connect to GPIO pin A1, the pull up resistor and the capacitor. So basically that is it. Now we can compile the project, the source code to create the firmware. So open the terminal, enter inside the NuttX project, execute make disk clean to clear previous compilation, enter inside tools, and configure the buttons example. Okay, yes. Enter in the menu config, in the board selection, just check board and board button support and board buttons interrupt support, and in drivers input, check the button inputs are defined. In application example, verify if the button driver example is selected. Now you can compile the source code. Okay, execute OpenOCD to write the firmware in the board. Done. Okay, now you can run minicon, reset the board, and execute buttons. Okay, when you press, it shows the sample bit coding for each pressed buttons. Okay, now we will modify the firmware to show the name of pressed button instead the bit encoding sample. Change the quantity of button to name the first to volume plus, the second to volume minus, and saving, and now you can compile. Okay, execute OpenOCD to write the firmware in the board. Okay, now execute Minicon again to run the application. Reset, okay. See, when you press the buttons, it shows the name of pressed buttons. Okay, that is it. Thank you very much. See you in the next video.